In other news, after 9 years, CNN Philippines announced it will stop operations on all of its media platforms, citing massive financial losses. Jackie Pascual with the details.
CNN Philippines shuts down effective Wednesday, January 31, 2024, with its last live airing earlier today. The company said it will discontinue its news production operations on all media platforms as a result of financial losses. CNN Philippines is a franchise holder of the CNN International brand, and they pay licensing fees to the global media giant. At the head office of CNN Philippines here in Mandaluyong, employees attended the General Assembly this morning where company officials, led by its president, Benjamin Ramos, officially announced the closure. He thanked the staff for their service for the past 9 years. Some employees say that they will be given a separation pay within the day, while others have already begun looking for a new job. Sources also added that a few or a select few employees will be extended for at least a month for transition purposes. CNN Philippines, aired on the RPN frequency, is owned and operated by the Nine Media Corporation with a brand licensing deal with Warner Brothers Discovery.
Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
House Speaker Martin Romualdez is now calling on the Dutertes to stop spreading lies about President Marcos, adding it's too early to wish for the downfall of the Marcos administration. He said the Duterte camp must make sure they have proof before making such allegations. Speaker Romualdez also hit Rodrigo Duterte for opposing charter change when the former president ran a campaign that pushed for a shift to a federal form of government.
Unang-una, baka nahirapan naman talaga si President Duterte kasi yung plataforma, kaya nanalo siya, ay federalismo. At yan, hindi lang yung amendment ng economic provisions. Ipagbabago yung buong sistema ng government. Mukhang hindi niya nakayanan. Eh ngayon na lang may nag-uunsad na magandang move for charter amendments, baka nakikita niya na yung hindi niya magagawa, baka mangyayari na ngayon, kaya baka sinisiraan niya.
Meanwhile, other House leaders are set to pass a resolution expressing the chamber's full support for President Marcos. They also assert the charter change the lower house is pushing is not political in nature.
If you read again, economic. It's not a secret. All the records are you can review all the records. It's always economic. We haven't filed and transmitted to the Senate anything about political. And you can check the records of the Senate, what we have transmitted to them. It's economic. So yung mga nagsasabi na to perpetuate the president or whoever in power, maybe they're in a different dimension at the time na, baka nga, fentanyl.
Asian markets struggling for direction amid major market moving news. In China, the world's second largest economy, a Hong Kong court on Monday ordered the liquidation of property giant China Evergrande Group, a move likely to send ripples through China's crumbling financial markets as policymakers scramble to contain a deepening crisis. The Hong Kong court decided to liquidate the world's most indebted developer with more than $300 billion of total liabilities. It says Evergrande had been unable to offer a concrete restructuring plan more than 2 years after defaulting on a bond repayment and after several court hearings. Trade on Evergrande shares has been halted. Now investors are also waiting for a slew of key economic data, the U.S. Fed's first rate decision for the year, China's factory activity figures for January, and Australia's Q4 inflation figures. All of that will be out on Wednesday. Taking a look now at the board, Chinese markets mixed after the liquidation order against Evergrande. This also comes as investors wait for Hong Kong's fourth quarter GDP numbers, which will be released on Wednesday. Meanwhile, the Straits Times Index in the red, even as Singapore's central bank kept its monetary policy settings unchanged, as expected. Now, taking a look at futures in Europe, they're pointing to a lower open after shocks in the region recorded two-year highs last Friday. Now, contracts tied to the London FTSE 100 are flat ahead of the Bank of England's policy decision this week, which comes a day after the Fed stateside. Now, stateside, futures are a little changed as investors also brace for a big week in earnings coming from mega-cap stocks. Let's open the week in corporate stories. Union Bank closes out 2023 with a lower net income. Its profit for the said fiscal year was down to 9.2 billion pesos against the 12.7 billion in 2022. Revenues were driven by strong consumer business and higher margins, among others. But Union Bank says integration costs from its acquisition of Citi's consumer business affected the bottom line. Meanwhile, BDO approves the merger of the bank with its subsidiary SM Keppel Land. The C-led lender announced an internal restructuring within the BDO group after the merger secured the approval of its directors over the weekend. It also came after BDO completed last month the buyout of SM Keppel Land from Keppel Philippines and Oron KE Properties. SM Keppel is the operator of the Podium Complex in Mandaluyong. And finally, ports giant ICTSI secures a 25-year contract to develop and operate a commercial port complex in Iloilo. Enrique Razon's firm vows to improve the terminal's productivity and service quality through the development of its infrastructure and the deployment of cargo handling equipment. ICTSI will start operations once it receives a notice to proceed with the Philippine Ports Authority.